Evening guys, it's Will here again, back with another battle report. Tonight, got a bit of a special one for you. First time of using the Genestealer Cult on the channel. Sam's got nearly 2,000 points of Genestealer Cult painted up already. He's just had to ally in a few Tyranid units to make it up to the 2,000 points that we're playing. And that's not because he hasn't painted them yet, that's because GW haven't even sent them out yet, because apparently orders don't arrive on time anymore. But hey, it is what it is. So we have the Genestealer Cult taking on My Salamanders. Thought this would be quite a nice thematic matchup. Looking forward to this, should be a good game. It's going to be 2,000 points doing standard Maelstrom of War missions. Now, just a quick note, I'm going to get this battle report up quite quickly because I think the internet needs Genestealer Cult battle reports right now. I've got two other battle reports already filmed, and to the guys who've played those with me, don't worry, you've not been deleted or forgotten. I'm just bumping this one up the order. The Batreps I did with you guys will be up shortly though. Just wanted to get this one out first so we could see the cult on the channel. But anyway, let's have a look at the armies. So here is my Salamanders. We've got 2,000 points here. We're going 2k because Sam's warming up for a 2k tournament in 5 weeks that unfortunately I'm not going to be able to attend. But we've gone for a flameblade strike force. So that's the formation from Angels of Death. Starts off with a standard demi company. So I've got my captain rather than Vulcan tonight. He's packing a Power Fist, a Combi Flamer, and Artificer Armor. Then there's a Command Squad with him, four Flamer guys in here, and my Apothecary. Then we've got three Tactical Squads, as you need for a Gladius, for a Demi Company. First squad has a Flamer and a Combi Flamer, and they're riding in a Rhino. Second squad, also 10 dudes. They've got Flamer and a Combi Flamer, but also bringing a heavy bolter with them, and once again they've got a Rhino. And final squad is just five guys, Melter, Combi Melter, in a Droplet. And then the support elements of the Demi Company, the Devastators, gone for 10, and they will be using, I've just been punched for some reason, I'm sorry, I've completely lost my train of thought, I just got whacked in the back of the head. Got two plasma cannons and two las cannons, 10 guys there, so they will be combat squadding. And then my bikes, my Salamander riders. So I've got five of these guys, they're actually mounted on Dark Elf Cold ones, but they're counting as bikes. And they've got three grav weapons in there, one combi and two regular. Then I've got two auxiliary choices. The Land Raider Redeemer, which is just an auxiliary choice in its own in Flameblade Strike Force. This thing's packing extra armor and a multi-melter. And then the formation of a Storm Raven, a Dreadnought, and a Stern Guard squad. Actually forgotten what it's called, Ravenclaw Assault Force or something, but basically the Stern Guard and the Dreadnought all ride in the Storm Raven. And it gets to deep strike and comes in hovering so they can get out and shoot the turn it arrives. And they also get rerolls to hit against one chosen target. This formation has 10 Stern Guard in it. So I've got two heavy flamers, a combi flamer, and three combi melters. They'll be combat squadding down. And it's just a standard Dreadnought with a multi melter and extra armor. Storm Raven's upgraded with the multi melter. So there we go, 2,000 point Flameblade Strike Force.
Right, and here's Sam's Genestealer Cult Army with Allied Tyranids. So what have you got here? It's the formation, isn't it?
Yeah, so for the Genestealer Cult, I've got the Cult Insurrection Detachment. So okay. I've got the First Curse, which is 20 Genestealers and a Patriarch.
And that's your command formation.
Yes, that's a command. The Patriarch's upgraded to a level 2. Mm-hmm. For my core, I went with the Neophyte Cavalcade, just because I'm going with that in how the whole army, when I finished it, will work. Yeah. So I've got a unit of 11, mm-hmm. two grenade launchers, unit of 10 with one grenade launcher, both in Chimeras, mm-hmm. unit of two Sentinels, yep. they've just got multi-lasers, and unit of two Russes with the Sponsored Heavy Bolters and the Exterminator Auto Cannons.
Very nice. And then for your auxiliaries?
I've got the Doting Throng, which is one Magus. Mm-hmm. Not one, but I've got the one. He's upgraded to level 2. 10 acolytes as 10 acolyte standard, and then 2 units of 5, 4 hand flamers, and 1 demo charge each.
Okay.
They're going to be my demo core guys eventually, so that's why they're like that.
When GW sends the damn Goliaths.
No, I've got them now, so.
You've got them, awesome.
Yeah, I need like 3 more boxes of acolytes to finish this army off. And just for a second auxiliary, I've got a unit of 8 Genestealers with Simon Hands.
Very nice. And then we've got the small Tyranid allied detachment here.
Flyerant, everyone knows him, everyone loves him. 20 Devourers.
No, everyone hates him, trust me.
Everyone loves the Flyerant. So, I've got 30 Termagants, there's 10 Devourers in there, 20 Flesh Borers, and 3 Lictors. I chose Lictors because they fit with the theme of what I'm going for.
Yeah, like the vanguard of the Hive Fleet. Yeah, very nice. Awesome. Anyway, to battle. So, Salamanders won the roll off to go first. We've rolled up a contact lost mission, so we get one card in the first turn, and then we have to hold objectives in order to generate cards. Not knowing where my opponent would be coming from, I've kind of spaced out along here, with both the Devastator combat squads going into cover to hold the objectives, 2 tactical squads in Rhinos spread out, Land Raider kind of up the middle and also covering the Devastators, and bikes out to the flank. Everything else is either in transports or in reserves. He's clustered most of his armour over on one side here by that objective. He called the Gaunts to chuck up the middle. And then the other Chimera and the Hive Tyrant are hiding behind there, like cowards. Now we're going to do the Cult Ambush. He's already rolled for his first unit, which got a number 1, which means they just come on the from the table edge. But we've got a whole load more to ambush. So all these guys have elected to infiltrate, which means they can benefit from Cult Ambush on the first turn.
Well, I can do it instead of ambushing infiltrating these guys. Mm-hmm.
So they can deploy within 3 inches.
Anywhere more than 3 and can assault.
Can assault, yeah. Nice. That's going to be nasty. And that's 20 Genestealers and a Broodlord. Patriarch.
Right, 10 Acolytes with the Magus. 3. That is just 9 inches away in sight, 6 inches out of sight.
Okay.
This unit, 5. Ooh.
Within 6 inches?
More than 6 inches away, and they can make a shooting attack the turn they turn up.
Nice.
And this one. 1. So they're 1 for the board.
So they're coming in on the baseline.
Let's just do them.
And then those 2 neophyte squads are in the 2 Chimeras. Yeah. Here we go then. So Sam had some pretty good rolls there. The Genestealers of the first curse were able to infiltrate right behind my Devastator squad here, so they're potentially in trouble on the first turn, especially as these guys definitely do get to charge first turn, unless I somehow find a way to wipe them out. Other than that, these guys came over this side. He kind of realised that the Salamander army has a lot of flames, and that kind of gets through his shrouded and is a real nasty thing, so he kind of protected his squad there and the squad behind there. And then we had 2 other squads deploying at the back. Apart from these guys, Colt Ambush didn't get him much, but yeah, he's now got a 20-man brood of Genestealers about to butcher my Devastators. But anyway, Sam, do you want to seize the initiative?
I do.
And he does. The Genestealer Cult seize the initiative.
Alright.
So after stealing the initiative there, the Tyranids had, the Genestealers had a pretty brutal first turn. So the main sort of body of his army just moved forward, Lictors, Termagants, Flyerant. The tanks were really good. The 2 Lehman Russes managed to wreck the Rhino already. And over on this side, my other Rhino got wrecked by the shooting from the Flyerant. Then the Chimera there opened up on this half of the squad that came out of this Rhino and killed another 3 of them, but luckily they passed their leadership. So that's 2 tanks down already. Over on this side, this unit moved forward a little bit and in the psychic phase cast Mental Onslaught onto my bikes. Now that killed one of them and left the rest of them at -3 leadership. He then shot me with his las pistols and got a lucky kill, meaning this unit had to take a leadership test at their -3 leadership, and that was significant. I rolled a 6, which would normally be a pass, but it meant they failed and fell back just shy of the table edge. thankfully these guys are Space Marines and will be rallying next turn. And then the final sort of insult to injury was the assault phase, where these guys quite predictably charged into my Devastators. I did manage to kill three of them, combined fire from Overwatch, and then get into hit first because they don't have grenades. But then they unsurprisingly butchered my Devastators. So yeah, pretty nice first turn for Sam. One consolation for the Marines is that he had Witch Hunter as his one objective, which he wasn't able to score due to there being no Librarian. So yeah, a good Tyranid first turn, but now let's see what the Salamanders can do to come back from this. Here's a hint. So, started my turn drawing Secure Objective 5, which to be honest is a pretty good one for me to have, because it wasn't too hard to score. I was able to move this squad over here just within 3 inches and barbecue a few Gene Stealers, but nowhere near enough, and I fear that objective is about to fall. But, you know, that scored me a point at least. I was a bit kind of at a loss of what to do. A lot of this stuff was a bit too far away to reach. So I pulled the rallied bike squad across here so they'd be a little bit safer for this turn, as there weren't really any good targets, and pushed the Land Raider forward. Command squad disembarked and proceeded to barbecue the lictors. Everything else kind of tried to take long-range pop shots. Laz Cannon put a hard point on the Chimera. Land Raider forced some armor saves from the Flyerant, but he saved them. And yeah, just generally trying to stick to the objectives. These guys tried to run up to objective 4, but didn't get a good enough run to get there. Other than that, Dropper came down over here. It was a little off where I wanted it to be. I was hoping to get the Melter guns into the side of the Lehman Ross, but I had to go for the front. Still managed to put 2 hull points on it and blow off one of the side guns, but not as much damage as I would have liked. But yeah, not a bad turn. As you can see, last turn a few of the Tyranid units went back into reserves, ready to cult ambush me again this turn. So yeah, here comes another nasty ambush. So, Tyranids had but one objective to this turn, which was to secure objective 6, which was easy enough since we already had a Lehman Ross sitting on it. Although, just for good measure, they killed most of that tactical squad, but he survived. The one guy left there passed his leadership test. Now, it's a big turn for Cult Ambush. A lot of units, like the squad over there and the Genestealer squad, all returned to shadows. But new units came on, the Sentinels. Came on, killed one of these guys with shooting. They rolled a 6, so they got a charge off as well. And yeah, we're able to kill. Are able to actually. Balls in. So, this turn, Genestealer Cult had one objective, which was to secure objective 6. And that was right over here, so nice and easy to do. Although, for good measure, the two losses did kill a few from that tactical squad, but the one guy left alive with Master's leadership. Now, a lot of units disappeared off the board. These guys that were over here went back to the shadows. The Genestealer unit went back to the shadows. These Sentinels came back up from reserve, rolled 6, and was able to get off the charge. Killed one tactical marine. When they charged in, actually immobilised one of them, but he was close enough to still be in coherency even after the other one completed the charge, but they drew the combat, and so that objective is still mine, because I'm upset. These guys popped out their Chimera, attempting to add fire to this fight here, but didn't achieve a lot. But in the middle, that's when things went really cool. One, 2 units of Acolytes with demo charges, and a unit of Genestealers all popped up in the middle here. The Acolytes both fired off their demo charges, killed the whole command squad, and tried to help the Land Raider. Didn't manage to kill the Land Raider. The captain was left alive thanks to his Iron Halo, but then fire from the Termagants and the Chimera just wiped him out as well. So that's a Warlord and a really deadly unit taken out. I think it was in the end actually the Flyerid who killed him with his what they called Devourers. So yeah, that's not good. But, you know, I've still got a good few units up, and he has got 3 points now, First Blood Warlord and his objective, but I'm getting at least 2 cards to draw this turn, and the potential for a reserve roll. Now, is he going to be at -1 because of the Genestealer's ability? But here we go, does my Storm Raven turn up?
Yes, it's a 4. Incoming Storm Raven. Okay, so turn 2 and the Salamander Flatback starts. Draw objectives 3 and 5. So 5 was nice and easy because this combat just rolled on. Nothing was going to displace them. Sentinels certainly weren't going to displace them easily, so that'd be mine. And then over here, my Storm Raven has sort of come round. So this locked onto the locator beacon of the drop pod as it deep striked in, thanks to its formation bonus, and then proceeded to drop out 2 combat squads, a Stone Guard and a Dreadnought. The Dreadnought and the Melter Arm Stern Guard almost killed the Lehman Russes, but I had to rely on the Storm Raven for fire support to finish them off, which meant this squad of Bean Stealers went unmolested, and the Chimera only took one hold on. This combat squad of Stern Guard and the Flamers almost wiped out the Gene Stealers, and the squad of Acolytes that were there were killed off by the tactical squad over yonder. Land Raider Redeemer trundled forward a bit and killed 5 from the Termagants, so not as many as I'd have liked, but hey, you know, it's still 5 kills. And the Devastators went for the Chimera, but thanks to some good cover saves, he was unscathed. Bikes had swung around the back to try and take a shot at the Hive Tyrant, but failed to do any significant damage. And the tactical squad sheltering behind the ruins there tried to kill the last of the Gene Stealers, but unfortunately they survived. Now, thankfully, they are within 6 of the Land Raider.
By a sliver.
So they can't run off the board this turn, but they're still going to be a thorn in my side, as are all these neophytes and gaunts. But objective-wise, pretty good. Managed to secure objective 3 with the Stern Guard and objective 5 over there. So that gives me 2 points, brings it to level pegging at 3-3 at the end of turn 2. So, again, just one objective for the Gene Stealers this turn. And this is one of the Gene Stealer-specific ones. It's basically have a unit come in from Cult Ambush for 1 point. And if it kills a unit, you get D3 points. Now, with his Warlord trait allowing his Warlord to pick his Cult Ambush result, that was a relatively simple affair. He picked Get to Charge this turn, and yeah, those Gene Stealers charged in and wiped out my Storm Raven. All in all, my little attack force over here really didn't last very well. The Termagants and these 2 surviving Gene Stealers wiped out the combat squad that was there, shot them, killed all bar 1, and then charged the guy that ran away. The Flyrant swooped around here, who's actually on top of that building, but he wouldn't balance there. And he managed to wreck my Dreadnought with shooting. So that just leaves this squad here in a very tight spot. But we are Space Marines and we shall fight to the end. Other than that, I mean, it was all focused really on this side of the battlefield. This Chimera managed to kill 1 from this squad, and the combat there grinds on. Now, that objective was worth D3, so Sam, do you want to do the honours?
Hey,
3 points. So that leaves the Tyranids, the Gene Stealers, on 6 points to 3 as we head into the Salamander third turn. So, some interesting objectives for the Salamanders this turn. Objective 4 was on a high location, so that was going to need a good run result. Supremacy, I've got the OPSEC, so that should be alright. Scour the Skies, there's a Flyrant, but with my Storm Raven down, there's not really much way to take him down, so let's see what we can do. Well, securing objective 4 was quite easy. This squad managed to get a 6 and then move through cover and sort of set up there, ready to hold that position, hopefully for the rest of the night. The Flyrant, I decided to leave alone. My best way of taking it down is gone, and everything else was really just going to be, not really effective enough. So I'll just leave him, forget Scour the Skies for now. Now, this squad over here, sitting on this objective, stood still to gain Fearless for my formation bonus and just fired Hellfire rounds into the Tyranids, killed 4 of them, which was effective, useful, but there's just so many of them. It's such a good unit, only 20 he can take with his first curse there. What else did we do? So the Bikes just tried to finish off that one unit of 2 Gene Stealers that was there. Killed 1 of them, and the drop pod killed the other. Land Raider pushed up, but the Termagants really blocking me, so I just flushed them out of the way,
support from this squad, but there's still too many of the buggers, and they're fearless thanks to Synapse from the Tyran. And down here, my las cannons fired at the Chimera again, to little effect, just stripped one hull point off it. So, yeah, not the best turns in terms of damage. This combat just grinded on to no effect, but I managed to secure objective 4, and I got supremacy, so D3 for that. Let's take a look. It's 2, so that's 2 points, which brings us back to 6-6 level pegging, as we head into what will be the 4th Tyranid turn. Turn 4, and once again, the Tyranids are only drawing one objective, but what an objective it was. Basically, for every unit he killed, he scored a point up to a maximum of 6. And yeah, he really went on a bit of a rampage there. So let's start over here. The Hive Tyrant and the Cultists and the Termagants wiped out the last remnants of, what were they, the Stone Guard. And that one lone Tactical Marine was killed by the other unit of Cultists over there. So that's them done. Then the Gene Stealers assaulted the Rock Pod, killed that, so that's 3. Down here, the Acolytes assaulted into the tactical squad that was there, wiped them out, did take a couple of casualties from Flamers on the way in, and then got a really good consolidation to get them back away from the Redeemer. And then finally, the Sentinels, thanks to some lucky rolling and some poor armor saves and a shocking leadership test, beat the tactical squad in combat, and they then failed the leadership test. I was like, okay, I'm 11 inches away from the edge of the wall, that should be fine here. Rolled a 12, didn't I? So bye-bye tactical squad, they're running off the board. That is 5 kills this turn. 5 kills. That's 5 points for the Tyranids, which may give us a bit of an insurmountable mountain to climb, but Salamanders are nothing if not tenacious. So here we go, Salamander, turn 5. So running out of units that could actually do stuff this turn, but you know, we're going to try our best. 100 for glory, get a challenge, and secure victory 6. Now, off 6 wasn't going to happen, because it's right over there surrounded by bugs, but 100 for glory I could get. Basically, I used my land raider and bikes to kill all bar the Magos from the Acolyte unit here, and then charged into the Magos and issued a challenge, and ran him over with Hammer of Wrath. So, yep, that's a point. I'm going to discard Secure Objective 6 because I don't see how I'm going to get that. It's given me 7 points, but the Tyranids are running away with it points-wise now. In other action, the Devastators managed to finally wreck the Chimera, and the Redeemer killed a few more Termagants. But yeah, it looks like it's going to be over pretty soon because I am surrounded and not in a good place. Here we go, Tyranid, turn 5. And turn 5 is really becoming mopping up time for the Gene Stealers. So the Flyrant came down here and finished off my Devastator squad. Squad that were there just lurked back into the shadows. We're coming back next turn, if there is a next turn. These two units, or three units, pulled back into his deployment zone to secure hold of the line, which is one of his objectives. And then behind enemy lines, he managed to get with that Sentinel. And then finally, the Gene Stealers assaulted the bikes and wiped them out easily. And yeah, just a really brutal turn. I'm down to a Land Raider and 2 depleted tactical squads. So yeah. We have one more turn to go, but I fear it is a little bit too late for the Space Marines now. So, turn 5. I have 1 objective card to draw. I need something to score me big points here to get back at these Gene Stealers. And what do I draw? Demolition, a card I can't even score. Now, we don't discard that because we're playing proper tournament rules here because Sam's warming up for the tournament. So, yeah, I can't score anything this turn. So just tried to really do as much punitive damage to this Gene Stealer unit as possible, just sort of in revenge really. So the Land Raider barbecued 6 of them and the tactical squad killed a few more, but that's really all I had left at this point. And the game ends, end of 5 we've decided to call it. It is 13 to the Gene Stealers and only 6 to the Space Marines. So thanks a lot for a good game, Sam, well played. And we'll catch you guys in a minute for the post-game. Okay, so yeah, pretty good game there. The Genestealer Cult were were suitably powerful, I think. How are you feeling with your new army?
I want more gains with them. I got quite lucky with some of the rules. I got like the Warlord trait.
Yeah, his Warlord trait allowed his Warlord to always...
choose which Kurt Ambush result I wanted.
Which always meant he was coming on and charging every
time.
He did
only use it once. Twice. Used it to deploy, but then he rolled a 6 to deploy anyway.
Yeah.
But then he used it to redeploy once. But,
yeah,
so.
The first curse assaulting off the
straight off the bat
off the ambush is just nasty. And then you stole the initiative on me as well.
Yeah, it's been a while since I've stole the initiative.
To
on
be
you.
Fair, it is. But to be fair, the last few months we've been playing no steel, so you know.
Yeah, you'll do it to me next turn.
I probably will. Yeah.
So yeah, that worked. The psychic powers I got were all a bit naff.
Yeah,
I got the shooty one and the mental onslaught, which are two of the weaker ones, and I got the summoning one, but I didn't really have anything to summon, nor did I feel the need for it.
No, so. I think you had everything you needed there. I mean, summoning would have been good, but like you say, you didn't have any spare models, because, not all the orders have turned up yet, but hey, that's another
what happens
gripe.
When Games Workshop runs out of a kit.
Yeah.
So, but yeah.
I think the Salamanders... didn't show their best today. We lost some key units quite early on, and
yeah, well, that's the thing. If I didn't steal the initiative, you would have moved forward. And you know, I destroyed all your maneuverability turn one by just wiping out all your rhinos. I was able to kill a unit, then get my Genestealers off the board, so there was no counter strike from your Storm Raven. Mm-hmm.
And I say that Cult Ambush gives the army such maneuverability. Not just to sort of go places quickly, but to effectively teleport out of tight situations and reappear across the board.
Most turns I was co-ambushing one or two units, and I didn't think I was going out of my way to do it. I felt like, no, this is actually quite natural, I'm out of position, I'll just do this. So it flowed quite well with the playstyle I was going with. I do need to get the Tyranids out of my list. I'm working on that. I still need 3 units of Acolyte Hybrids. I've got another Sentinel, so I'm upping them to 3, because 2 is just not powerful enough.
Yeah, you need that
work.
Third, yeah. But all in all, a really strong army. As for the Salamanders, I know the list I'm running is suboptimal at the moment. I am
You need to get yourself a few more Razorbacks.
I need a few more Razorbacks, maybe another couple of Whirlwinds to run a Suppression Force or something along those lines. But that's all in the pipeline. There's one Razorback on my desk. I'm rounding up the funds for another one. And then, yeah, might eventually be able to go double Demi Company, which will... give them a nice push. You know, of course, if I really wanted to make them super strong, I'd just say, yeah, they look like Salamanders, but no, they're actually Ultramarines or White Scars. Yeah. But no, I'm not doing that. I love my Flamers.
Yeah, I mean, it's a good count, Cole. Flamers are terrifying. I mean, I would have... If you didn't have so many Flamers, I probably would have deployed a bit more aggressively with some of my small units and attempted to flame you, to have loads of hand Flamers all over the place.
Yeah, those hand Flamers did a grand total of nothing against Salamanders, but against another army would have been good.
Well, I only put them on because I wanted to run Acolytes tonight, because... I don't have any Metamorphs, that's why I took the Doting Throng. Not that I think the formation came into any effect, but...
You just needed a formation.
Yeah, I needed a formation with Acolytes in that didn't have Metamorphs in. You'll find most formations that have Acolytes want Metamorphs as well, and I don't have any Metamorphs yet because the boxes haven't turned up. So,
but yeah, it seems like most of the stuff that we were able to test tonight from our review video seems to be the case. The Seam of Strong Army Cult Ambush is fun.
It definitely plays how I feel it would. The weakness of it being the vehicles, hence why I had so much shooting force. We can do a tactical on it at some point, but
I think
the basics of it is the reason I go for the Cavalcade over the Brood Cyclid, is the Cavalcade gives you some range shooting, so you can crack lighter armor transports.
Yeah, so the Russes took a Chimera down. I took a Rhino down on turn one. Yeah,
and the Hive Tyrant was a boss that game. Didn't make his points back, though, I don't think. He picked off like one or two Stern Guard, which finished off the squad. He killed a Dreadnought and a Rhino.
He killed my captain as well, finished him off, and he was like 150 points. So,
the Hive Tyrant was pulling his weight, which makes me apprehensive about taking him out. But at the same time...
You want to see what all cult feels like, and then maybe decide whether Tyranid Allies is the way to go or not.
Yeah, I mean, I got quite lucky rolling a 6 with the one of the demo squads. Getting that 5-man squad within 3 inches so I could actually use the demo charge.
Yeah.
So I had a thought as I was playing, it's like everything bar 6 says more than 6 inches away, and a demo charge is only 6-inch range, so I cannot use it unless I roll a 6 coming off the ambush. Or I can deploy using levels and be just out of your, out that way.
Yeah, but yeah, no, it worked pretty well and a good fun game. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching. After this, I've got another couple of bat reps coming soon. Games already played with my Eldar against Lewis's Tyranids and Jason's Ultramarines. Are they Ultramarines? Iron Hands? Sorry, it was a Space Marine army with about a million drop pods.
Yeah.
But then after that, you might well see more from the cult. So thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you guys again soon. Bye.